Welcome back. We've explored Farley's house, and we've learned quite a bit about the tree and the seed, apparently, that brought us here, as well as various other species that seem to live in different worlds that are linked to this one that we can reach using things called ambassador seeds, which is apparently what we used before the ambassador seed swap machine. Seems to be a way of allowing you to control going back and forth between these worlds. We also found a map, which when the projector was turned on, indicated something at the door where we saw the other control panel. And we also saw this pattern, which we can apparently enter on the number pad in the gas station. So, actually, I kind of want to go here. Because we've been doing a ton of stuff, and I kind of want to figure out what CW has to say about that. I also need to go to the waterfall. I keep thinking somebody's opening a door, but it's just like wind. Oh yeah, that's the imager I destroyed. I want to go to the waterfall and close that door so we can get across that bridge next time we are there. Might as well talk to Cecil while we're here. We're still very busy with something. Right. Well, that didn't really tell us much. Useful anyway. Except that we apparently need to get to the tree, get underneath it, to this heart place, and connect things back up. Because everything needs to be healthy for whatever it is he's planning to do. What exactly he's planning to do, I don't know. Get us home, I suppose. Don't know how he's hoping to accomplish that. One thing you might expect to be able to accomplish by turning the minecart around, by the way, is shield these, but since these don't have a red glow, they're real rocks, that doesn't do anything. Alright. Let's put this back up, and I think we actually have to bring the other side down. And we can close that. We can not move it any further still, because it's still blocked. But now, next time we're up there, we should be able to cross that bridge. And now we have a way of getting there. Actually, we have two different ways of getting there. We could go back through the wall on the other side of town, up to the plateau and the scrapyard, and go through the gas station. Or we can simply walk through Farley's house, which is obviously the shorter way of doing that. That will also take us back to the side of the gas station, which I will go to first. One interesting thing to note is that she mentioned, Farley in the tape we saw mentioned changing the message for that imager. So that's why that was such a weird message. She updated that last minute. So let's go to the gas station first and see what we can do with that pattern. This is where the game starts to involve a little bit of backtracking, but it's not too bad yet, especially as you are unlocking more shortcuts. I don't think you can actually walk off there to go over here. Let's see what happens when we put 15 in there. Yeah, like I thought, that was not a correct number. But it corrected it to 406. So maybe that's the number we need. It is a 3-digit code. And we did find this pattern right next to where a map was with an overlay that highlighted that one door where we need a 3-digit code. So, stands to reason, I guess. So let's head back there and see if 406 will get us anywhere. I need to go back here. And through here. And back through the dome wall. It's a sound you will hear quite a lot in this game. Oh, yeah, we closed this. So now we can get here. Oh, that did two things. It got rid of our block, so now we can presumably turn that the other way. Let me see how that helps us, though, because we can't get down there unless the bridge is this way. Guess we need to find a way to get to the backside of that locked door in there. Doesn't seem that we can get there from here, though, which is kind of weird. We'll probably involve more going through the wall. We have another shortcut to go down here, but it now no longer enables us to go back over there because there's no bridge there. And that door shut and cannot be manipulated from this side as far as I know. But it does give us a way to get back to like the rotating sphere and the gas station. Let's see where else this takes us. We're on the wall again, just on the other side. That seems to be taking us towards the tower, which is kind of hard to see. And there's the sphere. There's the battery and the windmill. Wait, that tower... Did they make that tower from a train? That's a train, isn't it? Put a train on its end to turn it into a tower. Now, that's inventive. More power lines going here. And an elevator. Presumably. Call button. Doesn't do anything. It's down there somewhere. Wait, wouldn't that be the door on the other side where we need the 3-digit code for? Possibly. What's this? 1, 5. Oh, it's just a phone. Looks like we need a 6-digit code to get into this elevator, which we have not yet seen anywhere. So, no idea what to do there. So, we gotta head back. Doesn't look like there's anything else up here. No more swap machines. Alright, let's go through here to our locked door. Nothing we can do with the swap machine yet because we have no idea how to get past the door in the jungle world, which I presume is Marais. What do we see? 406. That works. Oh, that's why you can't click that. It just slides open. And we are in our room. Vote for Yosef. I guess Yosef, the mayor, was here? At least during his campaign. Where does this door go? So we can open this. Oh, this is the back of the tree. We still need to get through here, don't we? Another shortcut, I guess. This allows us to get back to the town quite easily. That's good. So now we don't have to fiddle around with swaps anymore to get on top of the wall. Vote for Yosef and Yosef for mayor. More signs. Weird looking vase. Somebody needs to patch the roof, but I guess it doesn't rain here. Little sitting area with some notes. Mr. Mayor, at your behest, here's the information pertaining to the Bleeder, its history, and some of the engineering behind it. The Bleeder project was designed and built at the request of Mayor Sims to collect and dissipate the ever-increasing power in the entire ecosystem. Mayor Sims was reluctant to allow the system to come to fruition, as he and others had become suspicious of Major Farley's death. He believed that without knowing more precisely what would happen to the cell wall at fruition, it was ill-advised to allow it to possibly open, thus allowing what might be outside in, and what might be inside out. The system has the capacity to throttle all four connected worlds. The idea, as you are well aware, is to suppress the ecosystem power and thus inhibit full maturity of the trees. It was postulated, and since became apparent, that this suppression will keep whatever unknown maturity process from happening, and grant us direct control over tree fruition. There's another part to this. The rate of dissipation is sensed and regulated automatically. The power is collected through Villain-engineered extruded cables that attach directly to the dome membrane. When the maximum power level is exceeded, the dissipation phase is triggered, creating an electrical charge followed by a discharge into the water. Through electrolysis, an amount of hydrogen and oxygen is generated. We capture some of these elements for our own use, but the great majority is released into our atmosphere. This gassing might be a cause for concern were it not for the ecosystem's ability to filter and maintain our atmosphere at near ideal levels. Excess hydrogen and oxygen content and pressure generated by the process is rebalanced quickly by the membrane. And as you know, we discourage swimming when the Bleeder is operational. Regards, CW. Oh, that's the weird tower we've been seeing. Apparently that was built to prevent the tree from coming to fruition, which, as we saw from Farley's house, they don't know exactly what will happen when that does occur. Maybe we'll swap back home, but maybe not. I guess it seems that the mayor at the time of the Bleeder's construction was afraid that maybe it would open the cell wall, allowing whatever's outside in. And they were concerned about that because Mayor Farley died suspiciously. Here's a bunch of mayors. Lufer Roscoe, approximately 500 BH to 3 BH. Then Carl Hunrath from 0 to 10,220 AH. I guess that does confirm my before Hunrath and after Hunrath theory. Still don't think these are years, unless Carl lived for 10,220 years, at least. Maybe they're days. John Farley was mayor next, then Benjamin Sims, who apparently had this Bleeder constructed after Mayor Farley died. Caroline Farley herself was also apparently mayor at some point. And the current one is Joseph Peter Janssen, which pretty much confirms that he is Dutch if his middle name is Peter. He still doesn't sound Dutch to me. I guess it's just somebody trying to imitate a Dutch accent, the actor. But with a name like Joseph Peter, he has to be Dutch. There's no way he's not. Oh, I guess I could have just gone on up on that side. There must have been more mayors than that. What is this stuff? More backer reward items, I'm sure, yes. Still haven't turned that off anymore. Weird looking bust of someone. Creepy. And more books that we cannot interact with. It's a backer reward item, but it also kind of looks like it might be a logo representing this place, like the connected spheres or something. Don't know if that was intentional or not. There's also another notebook here. 17,125 AH. Special Council Session 2, or 11. I think it's 11. Okay. Discussed final approval of Farley's plan with regard to the imminent attack. The full council vote was unanimous, and I gave my final approval. Preparations update. Farley says that tunneling is almost complete. Tham informs us that the Valains just completed their construction and have started testing. 17,126 AH. Special Council Session 12. No one attended. I will inquire as to reason for their absence. 17,127 AH. It appears that the council members feel like we're having too many meetings. Since the plan has been approved, perhaps we can reduce our meetings to every 2 days for now. While I was asking Cecil about his absence, I also inquired about securing the tower area. Okay, I guess that means these are days and not years, because a meeting once every year, definitely not that often, and they're talking about moving it to every 2 days. 17,128 AH. Special Council Session 13. Cecil will provide a new key code for the lower lock in the next few days. Cecil was concerned about any survivors not having access, so it was decided that we would conceal the code in Farley's house and give the residents the location as they were being chambered. I also had him change the upper tower access code. A clue to that code has been placed under the direction of our first mayor. So we found a clue to the lower tower lock in Farley's house, which I assume was the pattern we entered into the number pad. And the upper lock, which is the phone thing, their clue should be under the direction of our first mayor. Wherever that is. That was Roscoe, wasn't it? We'll see if we can find that. 17,129 AH. I have decided to bring some of the more important mayor's logs with me for chambering. Specifically the initial Hunraf log, and then the logs that document the history of our conflict with the Mofang. I would think we would have an extra chamber available for historic documents. Well, I don't know what chambering is. I'm guessing they're moving all this stuff somewhere. Too bad. I would have liked to read that. 17,130 AH. Special Council Session 14. Only Tham attended. He informed me that, because of the dire circumstances, the others were either extremely busy or not inclined to have long discussion about the situation. I told him I would suspend the regular Special Council Sessions, and we would simply meet as the need arose. 17,131 AH. I paid a visit to Farley today. I asked her to check on the availability of a chamber for the documents. 17,135 AH. I spent the last few days collecting documents. I've divided them into two categories, chambered and vaulted. The vaulted are less important, but obviously worth making an effort to save. They can be moved into Farley's vault area. The vaulted category will also include any books that we've managed to collect through the years. Farley's vault area would be inside Farley's house, I would guess, but we didn't see a vault area. Unless it's that passage behind the door that was blocked. 17,137 AH. With less than a week remaining before chambering begins, the population is tense. We've had several town hall meetings to try to answer any questions, but the realities of the current situation make it difficult to assuage fears. So the people are going to be chambered too. 17,138 AH. Farley has informed me that there is one final confirmation from Shivar. If Farley does not hear from her by the end of 17,141 AH, then there is no turning back. There is an odd justice to Farley's plan in that whatever the Mofang bastards sent to kill us will be returned back to them. 17,140 AH. Special Council Session 15. A special meeting was called to go over the plans for the final time. Farley had several instruction sheets to distribute. the Mofang weapon illustration, a list of all souls that will be used as a basis for the Chambering Manifest, and a thorough summary of the battle plans. These will be distributed as necessary. No word from Shivar. 17.141 AH. Farley tells me that there will be at least one chamber available for historic documents. Any other extra chambers will be loaded with emergency provisions and medications, in case either Hunrath or Murray are completely destroyed. No word from Shivar. 17.142 AH. No word from Shivar. Death is on our doorstep. Curse the Mofang devils to hell. 17.143 AH. I am leaving to be chambered. This journal will remain here to inform any future souls of what our last days were like. So this is the same thing that Farley referred to. The fact that they wanted to hear from Shivar, and that no word means that the attack from the Mofang was about to happen. I guess the mayor was kind of micromanaging people, and they weren't appreciating that. What else is here? That's a backer reward item, which is a compass. I wonder if that even works here. It's the mayor's desk. I guess what we're in is the mayor's office. And it's another compass. Rhode Island. Okay. Roscoe. That was the first mayor, wasn't it? Wait a second. The notebook said that a clue for the upper tower code could be found under the first mayor's direction. Well, this is a compass, apparently belonging to the first mayor, and underneath it, it said Rhode Island. How does that help us? By the way, this is the one thing I had to use a hint for when playing, mainly because we were playing it on our TV, as we said before, and I couldn't read this. I didn't notice that this said Roscoe. If I had seen that, I might have made the connection. But I didn't, so I didn't. And there's another license plate here from the gas station, I guess. From Iowa. Still no Washington plate. For someone, may all your doors stay open, Mr. Someone. It's a doorstop. Okay. And another one of these warnings. I guess those are the warnings about the Mofang weapon that the mayor mentioned in his diary. There's another door here. I have a feeling I know where that's gonna go. Indeed, it's the door above the rotating sphere. Don't need to go there right now. But it means we have even more useful shortcuts. Because now we can use this place to get through from the town to the back at the gas station, and also onto the wall without having to take too many detours, which is very nice. Oh, here's our elevator. I guess we don't even need the code to go up. Or maybe we do. Elevator is currently non-functional. Maybe we could just climb up this rail. Guess that's not happening. That's where the upper one is. And then you can go all the way up to the tower, I guess. And there's another area down here. Looks like a... Is that a bedroom? Another note down there. I'm hoping that that will also let us get to that area below the tree that we saw. Maybe that will get us to the tree. But it seems like in order to get this elevator working, we have to figure out the clue of the direction of underneath the direction of the first mayor, which is Roscoe, we saw on the list. And this says Rhode Island. Where have we seen Rhode Island before? was one of the license plates in the gas station, which this other license plate here conveniently reminds us, in case you didn't remember. Let's take a look. Fortunately, we can get there very easily now. Which is why it's good that we get all these shortcuts. There is indeed a Rhode Island license plate. And it says CLU287. That is interesting, because we definitely only had numbers on that number pad. On the other hand, that number pad used a rotary dial from a phone as input. And as the phone booth over here shows us, we can change letters into numbers. So CLU would be 2, 5, 8. And then the 287. Maybe that is our code. 258287. Let's give that a try on the upper tower number pad and see if that lets us use the elevator and get into the tower. But we'll have to do that in the next video.